Good morning, students. Welcome you all in the class of English. Myself Kamal Nath, and I am going to teach you exercise of English. In the last two video sessions of this week, you all learned the question answers. We all discussed whole chapters question answers. And here in the third video session, we are going to discuss grammar based questions, which are very useful for all of us, and these are only the instruments which help us to improve English and make it better. Surely you will be interested to learn it. So let's start from first topic, that is grammar and uses, from chapter An Uncomfortable Bed. Grammar and uses. What is in exercise A? Let us see. In this exercise, student, you have been given some sentences, almost 8 sentences, and we have to underline the uncountable nouns. In each sentence, there is one uncountable noun. We have to underline that. So let us see. In the first sentence, there is a grain of truth in what he says. So you can see here the underlined word in this sentence, truth. I have already underlined for your convenience, so that when you write all these answers, all these questions, you must be correct, you must be quite accurate. There is a grain of truth in what he says. The word truth in this sentence is uncountable noun. Experience is a good teacher. Obviously, you can see the word experience, that is uncountable noun. It is abstract noun, and so it is uncountable. Their family has been in business for many years. In this sentence also, business is from word busy. From word busy is business, and that is uncountable noun. It is difficult to put out fires without an extinguisher. Here extinguisher is, the noun, and let us see next one. Here word difficult will be right here. It is by mistake that one then. It will be difficult. Fifth one. The coming months are a period of excitement. In this sentence, the word excitement is uncountable noun. Seaweed is a widely used component in shampoos these days. It is a friendship that was very special and rare. It was a friendship that was very special and rare. So friendship is already underlined. He received a shower of praise for his new book. Praise, no doubt, is a verb, and at the same time praise is a noun as well. That is noun as well, praise. Next exercise in grammar and uses, you have B, in which you are given some words in the box and you are told to complete the sentences with suitable indefinite pronouns from the box. First sentence you can see, that is already done in the book as well. Something tells me that it will rain this afternoon. I can almost smell the rain. So something that is indefinite pronouns, it is here already used in the sentence, and that is an example given in the book. Let's start from the second one. Has anyone seen my glasses? Here underline word anyone is indefinite pronoun that we have taken from the box, and that will be in the blank here. I don't think this fits. Could I try another, please? Many people have watched this film, but no one have liked it. No one. Here is indefinite pronoun used in this sentence. I don't have many music CDs, but Neetu has several. So here several is indefinite pronoun that is used in this sentence. Few can surpass his greatness as a music composer. So here, few in this sentence is indefinite pronoun. Both these cakes look delicious. I will be greedy and have one of each. So each in this sentence is indefinite pronoun. Just a few people have accepted the invitation, but most have refused. In this sentence, most that is used in this sentence is indefinite pronoun. Now you have here another topic, that is grammar. Here words in use, and here you have been told to match each of these words to a prefix that is given in your book, and then you complete these sentences with the correct prefixed words. Uncomfortable, dis, that will be what here, dishonest, okay, dishonest. Then will be here distrustful, with a dis prefix will only be distrustful. From the prefix I am, you can make here impolite. From un will be unexpected. So these are what here to be made, and after that we have to use these words in the following sentences. That is what here the next we are going to discuss. First sentence is here, the guest felt uncomfortable when his friends started quarreling. So uncomfortable word will be what here in this blank to be filled with the prefix un. The students are debating the question. It is always dishonest to hide the truth. So here in honest word we have added dis prefix, and so the word formed dishonest will be in this blank to suit the sentence. It would be rather impractical to wear sandals on a trek. Impractical. In third sentence, after his friends played a prank on him, he felt distrustful of them. Distrustful of them. Mother taught us that it is impolite to criticize a gift. Mother told us that it is impolite to criticize a gift. Next one, that is six. The unexpected ending of the story both surprised and amused her. That was unexpected ending. Means the ending that was given to the end of the story, last of the story, was unexpected. But it surprised also and amused also. Now we have here exercise B. B exercise, use these phrases from the next to rewrite the sentences. You have been given in the box here a group of words. You have to replace the words from the sentence, and then you have to use these words given in the box so that the meaning is not altered. Meaning will be the same. You can see here in the sentence clearly, I went to watch a film which did not receive good news. Now you see, the film did not receive good reviews. Reviews will be here. News is here, what here, the no doubt that I think will be here. Yeah, review. I went to watch a film which did not receive good reviews will be there, not reviews, news. The film did not receive good reviews. All the same, I went to watch it. Let us see. Her cousins were laughing at her. Alia did not seem to mind. Alia did not mind her cousins who were laughing at her expense. So that is here what to be replaced, at her expense. Third one, he took a quick look at his notes and then he entered the examination hall. Here he took a quick look, in place of that we have used cast a glance. Meaning of these words are the same as in the sentence, took a quick look, but here the words are changed. He cast a glance at his notes and entered the examination hall. Rohan's classmates gave him a lot of attention when he won the quiz competition. His classmates made much of him. Student, when in the beginning of the sentence is small, that will be in capital. Starting of the sentence must be in capital. When Rohan won the quiz competition, his classmates made much of him. So gave him a lot of attention is replaced by the word made much of him. We have some more here. Let us see. 5th and 6th. After a lot of thought, I decided to go to Himachal and not Kerala. I made up my mind. That is replacing the word decided to go. For that one, it is made up my mind to go to Himachal, not Kerala. I think my family has planned a surprise for my birthday. In a store for my birthday. So the words that replace the other words from the sentence make the same meanings, but phrases are same, and we should learn these words so that we too can use in our language, in a spoken, written, adding like ornaments, making it beautiful. That makes really beautiful. So these were what the exercises today, students, to discuss, and I am sure that you must have learned it, understood it. Thank you, students, very much.